Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to understand topological sorting. Let's begin this with a brief introduction of what topological sort is. Given a directed acyclic graph, topological sort is a linear ordering of its vertices such that for every directed edge from vertex U to vertex V, U comes before V in the ordering. That being said, let's see an ordering through an example. This is a directed graph and is also acyclic. The topological ordering for this graph can be any one of these two. Here you can notice how vertex B and C appears only after vertex A, and also that once B and C both have occurred, can vertex D come into ordering. We'll look into details of how a topological sort works, but before, let's see how it is important in real life application. So here are few of the applications of topological sorting. The first is build systems. You must have seen various IDEs like Eclipse or Sublime Text where there is an option to build your project. If your project has various libraries that are dependent on each other, then IDE can do a topological sort to know which library should be built first. The next is Advanced Package Tool, which guys familiar to Linux would know. For REST, it is a way in Linux to install and remove softwares. Thus, this tool does topological sorting of the list of packages to be installed or removed for a particular software program. Next application is task scheduling. Topological sort is helpful in scheduling interdependent tasks to know which task should proceed which one. The last one is prerequisite related problem. We often come across situation where we need to finish one job in order to proceed to the next one. This can be understood with a university course structure where we need to finish a course on introductory algorithms in order to study an advanced algorithm course. Thus, there exists a prerequisite and we can know this by doing a topological sort on all available courses. Now let's learn topological sorting through an example graph. Consider this directed acyclic graph with vertex from A to J. Let's also have the code given on Geeks for Geeks and an empty stack. We initially have all the vertices as unvisited, as shown by these color markings. Let's begin from vertex A. This for loop here will give us the unvisited vertex. Since vertex A is unvisited, we are good to go. The function topological sort util will be called with vertex A, visited array, and an empty stack. This function will mark vertex A as visited and make a recursive call for its unvisited neighboring vertices. Here vertex B and F are neighbors, but we'll choose alphabetically, so we come to vertex B. We visit vertex B and move to its unvisited neighbor H. We visit vertex H and look for unvisited neighbors of H. Since there are no unvisited neighbors of H, we push it into our stack and move back to node B. We see that B also have no unvisited neighbor left. So we push it into our stack and come to vertex A. Now vertex A has an unvisited neighbor F. We visit it, and since it has no neighbor, we push it into our stack and move back to A. Now, since all neighboring vertices of node A are visited, we push it into our stack. We then start with another unvisited node. We choose C and visit it. Since there are no neighbors, we push it into our stack. We again start with vertex D, visit it and move to its unvisited neighbor E. We visit vertex E and then move to its neighbor I, which is unvisited. We visit vertex I, and since there are no unvisited neighbors of I, we push it into our stack and move back to E. We now push E into our stack and move to vertex D. Since all neighbors of D are visited, we push it into our stack. Now we choose G and visit it. Since all its neighbors are visited, we push it into stack. Lastly, we choose vertex J and visit it. Again, all neighbors of J are visited, so we push J into our stack. Now, since all the vertices of graph are visited, we come out of this loop, and now it's time to print the content of our stack. This is how our topological ordering would be for this graph. Now let's have a look at the complexity of our code. Since we are simply doing a modified depth first traversal, this code will run in big O of V plus E, where V are the vertices and E are the edges. And with this, it's time to conclude this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestion, please leave them in the comment box below. Thanks for watching.